Hello, and welcome to this video tutorial in which we'll discuss how to implement a complex use case in a React Native project by bridging over native Objective-C code. A React Native plugin exposes a lot of JavaScript APIs, making the implementation of most use cases for PSPDFKit a breeze. However, sometimes there are certain iOS APIs that are difficult to port to React Native, mainly because of the design pattern, paradigm, and philosophy differences between iOS and React Native development. A React Native wrapper exposes the PSPDFKit view object, which is the main native UI component which uses an iOS view controller under the hood. In PSPDFKit view, we abstract away a lot of the internal functionality and APIs of the underlying PSPDF view controller to offer a better React Native JavaScript API. Where some use cases are concerned, it's a lot easier and more efficient to just implement them directly in Objective-C rather than exposing them as new JavaScript APIs. If you wish to learn more about how to extend React Native APIs, please take a look at our blog post here, where we cover this topic in depth. So before we get started, I'll be assuming that you're familiar with React Native and that you already have integrated PSPDFKit into your project. Otherwise, you can use our catalog sample project, which is bundled inside the open source repo, which I'll incidentally be using in this tutorial. So let's talk a bit about our use case. So in our use case here, we want to add a custom button to the annotation toolbar. So when you first present a PDF, this is the PSPDF view controller, and you tap on the annotation button and you have the annotation toolbar. So what we want to do is to add a custom button, particularly this trash icon, which is not part of the standard annotation toolbar. So what does this button do? It deletes all annotations in a document. So here I'll be adding a couple of annotations. And when I tap on the button, the annotations are gone. In contrast, if we look at the catalog example from React Native, we launch it and we don't have that trash button. So let's get started. This previous example was from PSPDF catalog, which is the sample project that we bundle with our native framework. You can download the DMG and you can access this example. So I'll be looking into it in Xcode. And this is the example in question. It's called PSC Annotation Toolbar Buttons Example. So this is the entire Objective-C example that we saw earlier with the trash icon. So I don't want to really go too much into detail about how it is implemented, but I'll cover it a bit like an overview. So essentially what we want to do is to have a custom toolbar with our clear button. So this is where we defined the subclass. We're subclassing, we're extending PSPDF annotation toolbar and we're adding a button to it. So this is the interface, the definition of the subclass, and below we will have the implementation, which is the entire logic. So what we want to do is to have this custom toolbar added to React Native. So now I'm going to our React Native catalog and I'll be editing the PSPDFKit view object. So this is the view that is wrapped to React Native. This is the Objective-C implementation, but we expose it as JavaScript. So what we're going to do, we're going to tell our internal PDF controller, which is a PSPDF view controller, to use the custom toolbar. So let's get started. So I'll define the interface here, and I will also copy at the very bottom of the file the implementation. So here's the implementation. So now let's run again the example and see if it works. So PDF view component, show the annotation toolbar, and as you can see, the trash button is not there. That's because we just defined the custom toolbar, but we haven't told PSPDFKit to use it. So how do we go about that? I am going to replace the initializer with a custom one that tells it to use it. So it's PDF controller. So here we're instantiating with an old document just like before, but we're setting a configuration object and we're overriding the annotation toolbar, the default one, with the custom button annotation toolbar, our current toolbar. So let's run the example again. PDF view component. And here you can see that I have the trash icon. I'm adding a couple of annotations again. As you can see, the trash icon is enabled because it detects that the document has annotations. And if I tap on it, the annotations are gone. So you can find this very example here in our open source repository. It's on the custom branch. So it's customize the annotation toolbar in native code branch. So you can just check out that branch and run the catalog example, and you'll see that button there. I hope that this tutorial will help you bridge Objective-C code to React Native so you can implement more complex use cases in your project. Thanks for watching.